Have you heard? NVIDIA is going to be making CPUs for Windows PCs as soon as 2025. I'm Theo, and that's what I'm going to be talking about. Now, this is not something I was expecting, but I guess looking at it now, it's not really surprising. NVIDIA has been making a boatload of money from their GPUs and their AI stuff, and I think Microsoft was basically looking for a partner to create CPUs, kind of like an equivalent idea to what Apple has been doing with their Mac M series CPUs. They kind of want something like that for Windows. And since Microsoft is definitely going to be wanting to push AI stuff in Windows going forward, since NVIDIA has that much experience with AI on the GPU side, it probably just made sense for them to kind of be the partner. Although I am curious to see how NVIDIA is going to be good at this. Now, Apple obviously did a really good job. Maybe NVIDIA will do just as good a job. I wonder how well that GPU experience translates to a CPU. Now, to be clear, it's not like these new ARM processors from NVIDIA are going to be the only Windows PC CPUs. Not even close. I think Microsoft is probably likely just going to have their own special line of it. And then, of course, there's going to be plenty of other manufacturers that just use Intel. And I do believe Intel is adding their own AI features. They definitely are, and probably going to be increasing that, as anyone could probably assume. And if you were not aware already, Windows already has a ARM version that you can download and run on an ARM CPU. I don't believe there's that many out there right now. I know Qualcomm makes some Snapdragon-based laptops, although according to some random person on Reddit, they're not very good. However, I do believe there was some very recent press conference, possibly just today, where they said that their single thread performance on their latest one is even better than the M2 Mac. Of course, Apple is about to release their M3 CPU, so that's probably gonna blow anything out of the water that they just showed. Now, you might be wondering, what's the benefit of having these ARM versions of Windows, these devices? And I guess it's like anything. It's not gonna hurt to have certain Windows PCs out there that you can sell that potentially are way more optimized for Windows and just perform extremely well. If Microsoft can pull that kind of thing off, where their devices are like a gold standard and actually perform better than anything you get with Intel, that would be profitable, obviously. Now, even though Microsoft does have a version of Windows that runs on ARM, you probably have not seen it before because it's not very popular. Again, really the only one you're going to see it on is like those Qualcomm CPUs, maybe some kind of like mini CPU or device like a Raspberry Pi that uses an ARM processor, but that would probably use the slimmed down core version of Windows, I believe it's called. Anyway, the point I want to make is there is going to be a compatibility consideration you have to make if you are running an ARM version of Windows. Namely, usually if software is compiled, it's going to be for a specific platform. And you might have seen recently that a lot of software that you go to download, there may actually be multiple versions of the Windows downloader that say x86, which is like the usual Intel one, and they might start now saying ARM64, and actually probably have been for a while, just because it's not too difficult, from my understanding, to just start having it compile the extra one, as long as whatever language you're using supports it. You kind of may as well release the software with that if you have the ability to. And this was kind of an issue when Apple first released their first M1 Mac devices. A lot of software was not really compatible. I'm not sure if they had any kind of emulation backwards compatibility thing going on. I assume they had that on some level, but it's not like you're going to get the best performance unless you have natively compiled versions for that platform. Now, Windows ARM does have an emulation by default thing in there, so you can actually run x86, is what it's called. You can run old programs on the ARM platform, and I believe it's kind of seamless, so there's no issue there. However, you have to remember that it is an emulated version. It's basically converting the instruction set of what the program's trying to do in the x86 instruction set and use it in ARM, and there is overhead with that. So if you're using a program that does not have a natively compiled ARM version, then there is going to probably be a hit compared to if you were running that on a x86 Intel processor. And that kind of got me thinking, would that actually be that big of a deal though? And I don't think so, actually. And here's why. I would think for the most part, if Microsoft announced they're going to be creating their own devices, like Surface devices that are ARM-based, that's going to tell developers, okay, we definitely have to start creating ARM-compiled versions, and it's not that hard to do. I don't think, but I could be totally wrong on that. But you'll definitely see the biggest software players out there compiling it for this version. So for the biggest software, most popular software, you're going to start seeing that roll out. And then for really old software that might not be updated at all anymore, it might be like abandonware, but people still use it, that software is probably so old that the hit you take from emulating it is not even going to make a difference, because the latest processors are going to be so powerful that it has no noticeable effect anyway. So I think as long as the emulation software, the conversion thing that Microsoft has going with the ARM version of Windows, as long as that's totally seamless and totally transparent to the user and works in all cases, I really don't think it would be too big of a deal. And actually, it could be possible that the gains in performance and optimizations that they get from having custom-made CPUs, that could actually potentially cancel out any emulation issues. And then if there is software that's natively compiled for it, then it'll just be even better. So that's kind of what I would expect to see. Although remember that I'm not an expert in hardware, so I could be completely wrong in that. Do not take my opinion as something that's likely. Again, though, to emphasize, I do not think that this means Microsoft is expecting or even wanting to get rid of Intel on Windows. Obviously, most devices are going to support Windows, and most people are going to be buying Windows devices, and then I think it'll probably just be some kind of specialized line that Microsoft will create that they can really sell themselves for some kind of premium, and that'll be their wheelhouse. And probably it would be a really good way to get Intel to follow their vision more. So maybe Microsoft wants to implement certain types of AI features that Intel is not. I don't know if this is the case at all. I'm just saying, then if Microsoft on their flagship devices gained really good performance with this certain specific AI feature, then of course Intel would update their future processes to kind of match that. So they'd kind of be able to influence Intel and influence features on all devices, maybe like by AMD as well, and even Apple going forward. But of course, Apple would likely be able to do the same. I mean, they kind of already have given Microsoft the idea, hey, maybe we can make our own CPUs as well using NVIDIA. So we'll have to see. Again, most of this was just speculative rambling, but let me know what you think down in the comments. Are you excited to see this? Would you buy a specialized ARM Windows PC made by Microsoft purely? Well, I guess NVIDIA is helping them design the chips, but you know what I mean. And if you found this video interesting, definitely give it a big, giant, huge, enormous, big thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. And if you want to keep watching, here's another one to check out where I talk about how you never have to wonder again what weird error messages in Windows mean. I show you a really cool way to look up the error message just in Windows itself. I'll put that link right there. You can click on that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.